So for the P4 Lewis structure, it's a bit more difficult. We need to think in three dimensions. So we're going to have a triangular pyramid. So at the base of our pyramid, we're going to have a triangle, which you can see on the screen right now. We'll then add the top of our pyramid. So you can imagine that these two ends in the front, they're out towards us, and then this part right here is back in the screen, and then we have the top of the pyramid. We're going to put a phosphorus atom on each corner. So we've used the four phosphorus atoms that we have for the P4 Lewis structure. Remember, this phosphorus right here is going back into the screen, while these two are closer to us. So we have a total of 20 valence electrons for the P4 Lewis structure. If we count the bonds we've already formed, we've formed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 chemical bonds. So each of those lines represents a chemical bond, and each bond is 2 electrons. So we've used 12 valence electrons. And you can see each of the phosphorus atoms only has 6 valence electrons. It has 3 bonds going to it. So it needs 8 for a full outer shell, for an octet. So let's go around and fill the octets of the phosphorus atoms until we get to the 20 valence electrons we have for the Lewis structure for P4. So we have 12 we've used, 14, 16, 18, and 20. So we've used all 20 valence electrons, and you can see that each of the phosphorus atoms now has 8 valence electrons. So there's 3 bonds, so 6 valence electrons there, and then the 2 that we've just added. So all of the atoms have octets, we've used 20 valence electrons. That's it. That's the Lewis structure for P4. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.